Hey, this is Josh Stern.
And Michael Walters.
With a Millionaire Agent Mindset tip for you. So I've been selling real estate for over 15 years, and my team and I have sold over 2,000 homes along the Wasatch Front. I'm also a mega achievement productivity systems coach for some of the top real estate teams in the world, and I'm focused on helping you to achieve your own greatness potential. Today's video tip is how to make your future self proud.
Yeah, so let's talk about how the short-term thinking prevents long-term results. Let's do this by starting with the Millionaire Real Estate Agent Organizational Chart, levels 1 through 4. A level 1 agent is you and you alone. This is a previous model for realtors, and this is the individual agent and how it's been up until teams began in, about the 1990s, and really began to blossom after the release of the Millionaire Real Estate Agent book from Gary Keller. After level 1 is level 2. Level 2 is, and 3 is where I see a lot of breakdowns in nearsightedness. You see, as an individual agent, we like to keep as much money as we can. So our initial hire, we like to call an admin, but we treat like a buyer agent.
Yeah, I've seen this happen a lot. What Michael's saying is this: we tend to hire help and not want to pay them, so we expect them to go out and sell some homes. And the problem with this is that they're not bringing someone in who can actually help us to build systems to handle future volume. Additionally, we're not offering our 80% that doesn't deliver the results we need to move forward, right?
Yeah, right.
So remember the 80-20 rule: 80% of the results are generated from the 20% that matters most. As an agent, your 20% that matters is an acronym that I use called SLACK with two L's. That stands for scripts, lead generation, lead follow-up, appointments, and contracts.
Yeah, so the third level is agent plus two assistants. Again, lots of breakdowns here because an agent, now called a rainmaker, has a tendency to want to keep more money, not spend money.
Right.
So they commonly would bring in a buyer agent here instead of a second administrator. Our second administrator is what really begins the momentum into the fourth and fifth levels.
Yeah, you see, the first administrator will now typically be involved with the transaction listing and client care coordination, while the second administrator will be focused on marketing and customer-oriented systems to streamline the rainmaker's real estate business. Now we're running like a well-tuned Ferrari. Okay, maybe it's more like a Ford F-150, but we're moving forward nonetheless, and momentum and systems are on our side.
Yeah, so it's time to hire our first buyer's agent, and this is really where I want you to consider your future self. We don't want to hire just anybody, and it's reality. We're not hiring a buyer's agent. We're hiring our future leadership. So as you approach the fifth level, you should have a director of operations over your administration team.
Yeah.
And you have a lead listing specialist over your listing side and a lead buyer specialist over your buyer's team.
Okay.
And at the sixth level, your leadership will grow into true leadership roles in the form of a director of sales. And they're over all of your agents,
right?
Recruiting, training, and accountability. You may have a director of operations, and they're over your entire administrative success team. And a director of lead generation, where they're over your lead generation systems and your ISAs and OSAs and training.
Yeah, and here's the thing that you guys have to realize. First of all, it's gonna take you like 4 to 12 months just to find and hire true talent. It takes them 3 years to learn, earn, and own leadership positions. Your first talented administration hire will likely become your director of operations. Your first agent should be talented, and they will earn and own your director of sales position. Think ahead. Always be thinking 3 years ahead. Never hire out of emergency. Therefore, once you get to level 4, you will make recruiting, selecting, training, and leadership a priority, and you'll be scheduling probably about 10 to 20% of your time on this job. See, you're always going to be recruiting to build your team with talent, and you're going to have a bench of talent in the waiting. When we hire to like an immediate need, or we hire to the amount of transactions that we want to do in 1 year, we're actually being kind of short-sighted.
Yeah, and we must be thinking long-term. As a rainmaker, we must follow proven models. We must have a clear mission, vision, values, belief, perspective for all of our business.
Okay.
Our vision must be big enough to include our talented hires to be able to fulfill their vision and life's purpose within our organization.
I agree. So when we hire an agent or an administrator who's real talent, they're going to want opportunity. It's your job to show them the pathway from transaction coordinator to director of operation. It's your job to show them the pathway from a buyer's or listing agent to a director of sales. It's your job to show them the pathway from an ISA or an OSA, which is inside sales and outside sales, to the director of lead generation. This is the only way you're going to be able to retain talent talent and slow the turnstile. Where do you want to be in 3 years to make your future self proud?
Yeah, and that's what you must focus on right now.
Right, and what you focus on
expands.
So feel free to visit our website, Real Estate Careers in Utah, to sign up for our agent newsletter.
Or book our one-on-one appointment with our team and dive deeper into the valuable conversation about you and your business.